Streamlined Weatherization Improvements for Tomorrow project, or SWIFT for short. Let's take a look inside this Department of Energy funded initiative to weatherize low-income homes in North Carolina. Led by UNC Charlotte professors Thomas Gentry and Rob Cox, SWIFT may well become a national model for making homes more energy efficient.
The Weatherization Assistance Program, which is called WAP, has been around for about 30, 35 years. And as you might guess, over that time, there's been a lot of changes in housing and the technology that goes into housing. So the U.S. Department of Energy put out an RFP for a program called WIP, which is Weatherization Innovation Pilot Program, and to have organizations develop a new weatherization program, which is what we've submitted. Our SWIFT program, which stands for Streamlined Weatherization Improvements for Tomorrow. There's a lot of acronyms involved in this industry. We were one of 16 grantees chosen to be funded for this project and the only academic institution to receive funding for this. Ours tends to be fairly heavy in terms of the research. We're focusing on both the technology and in education for the homeowners. Our goal is to weatherize 800 low-income houses throughout North Carolina. Those are actually to serve more as basically our laboratory in terms of developing the program and evaluating the program. So there's the community service component in actually doing the work, but in terms of the research, it's what we're doing in those houses that we're looking at. The educational component has got a couple different facets to it. We're installing real-time power monitors in the house so that the homeowner can actually see how they're using energy in the house. We have two basic types of partners. We have the leveraged partners, and the reason why we have them is that DOE strongly requested that for every federal dollar that we spend on the project, that we leverage $3 in funds or in-kind services. So the leverage partners include Lowe's Home Improvement Center, who's giving us a substantial discount on the materials, North Carolina Housing Finance Agency, which is providing forgivable loans to the homeowners, and the Habitat for Humanity. They're providing volunteer labor, access to the homeowners, some of their staff time, but they're a big part of the project. So those are our leverage partners, and then the folks from Energy Inc. who are providing the TED devices, they're also providing those at a discount. And then we have our small business partners, which are the contractors that are in this project, and that involves Shere Com and Shake the Lake. There are a couple favorite parts of the projects. Working with the homeowners is great. Every once in a while it gets kind of frustrating with all the bureaucracy and everything else you go through, and you kind of question, why am I doing this? Then you sit down and work with the homeowners, and it's like, wow, this is really kind of a great experience, because they genuinely are appreciative. And then the research side of it. I think it's a lot of fun to just be able to come up with an idea and then play with it and see how it really does have opportunities to improve people's lives.
In these habitat neighborhoods, all of the homes are kind of clustered together, and we went through door to door basically trying to get people involved and, you know, get the word out that this project was going on. And we were just walking through the neighborhood, and a homeowner came out of her house. I think they were actually leaving to like go somewhere. It was a Saturday, so they were leaving to go somewhere. And she kind of came running out and wanted to know what was going on, and got really excited and said she'd be at our community meetings. And, you know, she was just really excited about it. And we need people like that in the neighborhood to kind of help us spread the word too. They're community leaders is kind of how we're looking at them. And so they're kind of our liaison between the university and the neighborhoods themselves. The most interesting part of this project to me is kind of where lifestyle choices meet technology and how it's really a balance of the two. You know, we're educating these homeowners on how to effectively or efficiently use this technology in their home that will help them conserve energy and lower their energy bills every month.
So a lot of my past research focuses on energy monitoring and how energy data can be used to be able to detect problems in systems and to be able to figure out where energy efficiency is a problem. And a lot of our previous work has been focused on military customers or commercial buildings, some residential cases. In applications in the residential space for energy monitoring, it's been a hard time for a lot of companies who've tried to get into that, really because it focuses on sort of niche customers who don't see a whole lot of value in it. And one of the things that we're really trying to do through this project is to figure out how we give homeowners the information they need to make smarter energy decisions. For the low-income customers, it's a huge deal, and that's one of the things that's been very positive about this program. So we're trying to use the research that we've done to be able to figure out how to best interact with these homeowners. As we look at it, you know, we can focus on passive methods for improving the house, and we do that by air sealing and insulating and things like that, basics. Then what we want to do is be able to sort of go that last mile and figure out how we extract more savings. The easiest way to do that would be to make a smart house, but that's expensive. So the alternative is to install the energy monitor and be able to give people the right information to make good decisions. In that case, we're trying to make a smart house by making a smart homeowner. And that's one of the big things that we're trying to do through this project.